Greetings, my friend. Welcome back to Space and Jer. Looking at the cloudless night sky, it's impossible not to enjoy the beauty of the shining stars covering the dark space. Most likely, in the foreseeable future, humanity is not destined to get even to the nearest of them, let alone those located in other galaxies. As in the case of you and me, the life cycle of stars is finite. Stars are constantly being born, live their long lives and die, leaving behind white dwarfs, pulsars, or black holes. In this video, we will talk about the life of stars, find out why they are so different, what is the main sequence, and also go on a journey to some amazing star systems that hide a lot of secrets and bizarre phenomena. Get ready! And let's go! We know that stars are born from a gas dust diffuse medium during the process of gravitational contraction of gas clouds under the influence of their own gravity. The result of this contraction is a protostar, a stable pre-stellar body in which thermonuclear reactions have not yet begun. As the mass of the protostar grows, so does its own radiation, the pressure of which eventually stops the gas and dust falling on the protostellar surface, and then begins to repel them. At this moment, the newborn star enters a hydrostatically equilibrium state due to the fact that with a sufficiently large mass, a new energy source is turned on inside the star. Using the example of the Sun, we know that this source is thermonuclear reactions. When these reactions begin, the star finally switches to the so-called main sequence, on which it remains most of its life. So what is the main sequence? The main sequence is a stage in the evolution of stars, in which the only source of energy of a star is thermonuclear reactions of helium synthesis from hydrogen occurring in its core. At the moment when this begins to happen, the age of the star is considered zero, and it is at the so-called initial stage of the main sequence. Luminosities, sizes and temperatures of main sequence stars vary in a fairly wide range. There are luminosities from 10 to the power of minus 4 to 10 to the power of 6 solar luminosities, radii from 0.1 to more than 10 solar radii, and temperatures from 3 to 50,000 Kelvin. Nevertheless, all these magnitudes are closely related to each other, as a result of which the main sequence stars in the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram occupy an almost diagonal band passing from bright blue stars to dim red ones. The main sequence stars have luminosity class V. 90% of all stars, including the Sun, belong to the main sequence, which is due to the long duration of this stage of stellar evolution. The above parameters are determined primarily by the mass of the star. They are also affected by other properties, but to a much lesser extent than the mass. So if we consider a star to be a black body, then its luminosity L is proportional to the square of the radius R and the fourth power of the effective temperature T according to the Stefan-Boltzmann law, where sigma is the Stefan-Boltzmann constant. There is also a mass luminosity law from which the dependence of luminosity on mass can be expressed as L proportional to m to the power of alpha, where alpha equals 3. However, for real stars, alpha can vary from 1 to 5 in different mass ranges. The relationship between mass and radius is often described by a similar ratio R proportional to the mass to the power of beta, where beta takes a value of no more than 1 in different mass ranges. In any case, all four parameters turn out to be closely related. Theoretical limitations on mass limit the range of other parameters of stars. The maximum mass of stable stars is about 120 solar masses. Although more massive stars are known, they turn out to be unstable, pulsate and lose mass, throwing matter into outer space until they become stable. The lower limit of the mass of a main sequence star is about 0.08 solar masses. With a lower mass, the star is unable to support the burning of hydrogen in its interior and becomes a brown dwarf. For example, one of the smallest known stars that can be attributed to the main sequence is the red dwarf 2-mass J0523-1403 of spectral class L1 in the constellation Lepus at a distance of 40 light-years from the Sun. this star is so dim that has a luminosity of only 0.000126 solar luminosities, a mass of about 68 Jupiter masses, a radius of 0.086 solar radii, and an effective temperature of 2074 Kelvin. These values are some of the lowest known for a main sequence star. Another small main sequence star is Ross 128, a single red dwarf of spectral class M4 in the constellation Virgo, located at the distance of 11 light years from the Sun. Its mass is 0.168 solar masses, its radius is about 1/5 solar radii, and its luminosity is only 0.00362 solar luminosities. This star is notable for the fact that there is one of the closest Earth-like exoplanets to us, located in the habitable zone. The exoplanet Ross 128b was discovered in 2017 by the Doppler method at the Chilean observatory La Silla. The discoverers of Ross 128b believe that it is the most temperate planet known at the moment, due to its mass, temperature, and location around a fairly calm parent star. It is the second most distant known terrestrial exoplanet from the solar system after Proxima Centauri b. It is assumed that the temperature on the surface of the planet lies in the range of minus 60 Celsius to 21 Celsius. The exoplanet belongs to the terrestrial planets and is one of the most suitable candidates for potentially habitable exoplanets. Research in 2018 confirmed that the planet's climate allows for the existence of life on it. Now let's travel to the Tau Ceti system, a sun-like star of spectral class G8.5V, located in the constellation Ceti in the southern hemisphere of the stellar sky. Located at a distance of almost 12 light years from the solar system, it is one of the closest stars to us and the closest single sun-like star. Tau Ceti is slightly smaller than the Sun in size. Its mass and radius are 0.783 and 0.79 of solar ones respectively, and the luminosity is about half of the solar. Because of its stability and similarity to the Sun, Tau Ceti was chosen as an object for the search for alien intelligence by listening in the radio band. Due to its significant brightness and extremely low chromospheric activity, Tau Ceti has become a tempting target for extrasolar planet search programs since the 1990s. In December 2012, a group of astronomers announced the discovery of 5 exoplanets near Tau Ceti. The planet Tau Ceti e, with a minimum mass of 4.3 Earth masses, fell on the inner edge of the habitable zone. On its surface, water can theoretically be in a liquid state, which means that there are conditions for the existence of living organisms. The planet receives about 60% more light than the Earth from the Sun, which heats it up a lot, and perhaps it has the conditions necessary for the emergence of life of only simple thermophilic organisms, a type of extremophiles thriving at temperatures of 45 to 122 Celsius. If there is an atmosphere similar to Earth's, then the average surface temperature of the planet will be almost 70 degrees Celsius. The climate on Tau Ceti e, therefore, would be due to a strong greenhouse effect, which makes the planet more like a super Venus than a super Earth. Without additional information about its atmosphere, scientists are not yet able to make a statement as to whether it is warm or hot, similar to Venus, which is unsuitable for life. Let's continue our journey by visiting the star system closest to the Sun. This is Alpha Centauri, which is a triple star. The two components, the Sun-like Alpha Centauri A and Alpha Centauri B, are visible to the naked eye as the third brightest star in the night sky. The third component is the invisible to the naked eye red dwarf Proxima Centauri, which is located from a bright binary star at an angular distance of 2.2 degrees. All three are the closest stars to the Sun, at a distance of about 4.36 light years, and at the moment Proxima Centauri is somewhat closer than the others. The two main stars, Alpha Centauri A and Alpha Centauri B, belong to the main sequence and are close in characteristics to the Sun. The age of the system is estimated as 6 billion years. It's more than the age of the Sun, which is 4.5 billion years. Both Alpha Centauri stars rotate around a common center of mass in an elliptical orbit with an orbital period of about 80 years. The kinematic characteristics of Proxima Centauri differ from those of the main stars of the system. Proxima Centauri is located approximately in 15,000 astronomical units from the two central stars of the system. The period of Proxima's revolution around Alpha Centauri AB is about 500,000 years. There is one confirmed exoplanet known in this system, Proxima Centauri B, orbiting Proxima Centauri. It is located at a distance of approximately 4.22 light years from Earth and is the nearest known exoplanet and at the same time the nearest exoplanet located in the habitable zone. The planet rotates at a distance of about 7.3 million kilometers from Proxima Centauri with an orbital period of about 11.2 Earth days. Despite such a close distance, due to the weak luminosity of the star, the planet receives just enough heat so that the water on its surface can exist as a liquid and not freeze into eternal ice. The minimum mass of this exoplanet is about 1.2 Earth masses. Proxima Centauri b receives from its parent star about 65% of the light that the Earth receives from the Sun, having an equilibrium temperature on its surface of about minus 40 degrees Celsius. According to the estimate, Proxima Centauri b currently receives 60 times more high energy radiation and 400 times more X-ray radiation than the Earth. This is despite the fact that this exoplanet does not have a magnetic field and the total amount of radiation received since its formation exceeds from 7 to 16 times the amount of radiation received by the Earth. Such indicators allows for the possibility of the existence of a biosphere using biological fluorescence as a protective mechanism against flashes of ultraviolet radiation from Proxima Centauri. This phenomenon, known in some species of coral polyps, can theoretically be observed as a temporary biosignature on exoplanets orbiting stars with active ultraviolet radiation. Since Proxima Centauri is a red dwarf, any planet in its vicinity will always be turned to it by the same sign. This phenomenon is called tidal locking, and it would greatly complicate life on Proxima Centauri b if it existed there. Gradually raising the stakes, let's go to the mysterious double star Achernar, which is the brightest in the constellation Eridanus. Of the 10 brightest stars in the sky, Achernar is the hottest and the bluest. The main star rotates extremely fast around its axis, at a speed of about 310 km per second, which is why it has a strongly flattened shape. Achernar A is a star of spectral class B3 VPE and has a mass of about 6 solar masses and a radius of about 7 to 9 solar radii. Its luminosity is almost 3,500 solar luminosities, and the temperature, due to its highly elongated shape, varies significantly depending on the latitude, with an average value of about 15,000 Kelvin. At the poles, it reaches values over 20,000 Kelvin, falling to 10,000 Kelvin at the equator. The high temperature at the poles leads to the formation of polar winds that carry away the substance of the star and form an outer shell of hot gas and plasma around the star. Achernar B has a mass of about 2 solar masses and a radius of 1.7 solar radii and is a white star of spectral class A1V A3V with a luminosity of 17.5 solar luminosities. From the amazing Achernar system, we are going to another unusual system called Theta 1 Orion C, a bluish star in the constellation Orion, located 1,500 light years from Earth. The star belongs to the main sequence and has a spectral class of 06V PE. It is a member of the Trapezium cluster, located in the Orion Nebula, and the most massive of the four bright stars in the center of the cluster. It is the hottest star visible to the naked eye and one of the brightest known stars. It is 33 times heavier than the Sun, 11 times larger, and its luminosity is 204,000 solar luminosities. The star is a source of powerful ultraviolet radiation that is slowly ionizing and possibly scattering the Orion Nebula. Ultraviolet radiation is also the main source illuminating the Orion Nebula. The star emits a powerful stellar wind, which is hundreds of thousands times stronger than that of the Sun, and emits plasma at a speed of more than 1000 km per second. Infrared observations of Theta 1 Orion C have shown that it is actually a closed binary system. It has optical variability and is a variable source of X-ray radiation. It is expected that this star will inflate at the end of its life, turning into a red supergiant, and within a few million years will end its life with a supernova explosion. And finally, let's go to the amazing star BI-253 of spectral class O2V in the Large Magellanic Cloud. With a mass of about 100 solar masses, a radius of 14 solar radii, and a luminosity of 1,175,000 solar watts, with a surface temperature of 54,000 Kelvin, it is one of the hottest known main sequence stars and one of the most massive and brightest among known stars. BI-253 is a runaway star because it is in relative isolation outside the main areas of star formation in the Tarantula Nebula, as well as due to the high spatial velocity. The star was probably ejected from the R136 cluster about a million years ago. The rotation speed of BI-253 is about 185 km per second, which is typical for young hot stars, and may also indicate some unwinding during star formation or merging in a close binary system. BI-253 has so far supported nuclear hydrogen combustion reactions in the central region, but the surface of the star is rich in nitrogen and helium due to rotational and convection mixing, as well as due to the presence of a powerful stellar wind. The star is close in position to the initial main sequence of a star with a mass of 85 solar masses. It is assumed that more massive stars, even on the main sequence, will belong to the luminosity class of giants or supergiants. With this, our journey through the stars of the main sequence has come to an end. I hope it was interesting. Thank you for being with me. If you like this video, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe to the channel, because it really motivates me to make new videos. And I will see you again soon.